Killer whales are the largest species of dolphin. But wait, if killer whales are dolphins, why are they called killer whales? Should we just be calling them orcas instead? Hey everyone, if you're new here, I'm KP, a marine biologist who specializes in marine mammals. While I'm currently known for my work with walruses and sea otters, in the early half of my career, I worked with beluga whales, Pacific white-sided dolphins, and even a false killer whale, who was rescued after becoming stranded on a beach when he was basically just a newborn. We'll get to false killer whales in a moment, because as you can probably already tell, the naming of marine mammals is a bit ridiculous. For example, the crab-eater seal does not eat crab. Fur seals, not seals, they're actually sea lions. And sea lions? They're obviously not lions, and they're far more closely related to bears. But so what about killer whales? Recently, I did a video on three crucial studies about orcas. That made it crystal clear that the southern resident killer whales are highly endangered and will likely go extinct within my lifetime, unless we take the necessary steps to protect them. But because this is the internet, instead of being upset about the threats that these iconic animals face, my comment section is full of people calling me out for using the name killer whale instead of orca, saying things like, please don't call them killer whales. They're not killer whales, they're orca. Calling them killers is degrading. And they're dolphins, not whales. Stop calling them whales. And yes, killer whales are dolphins, but scientifically speaking, dolphins are whales. Let me explain. All whales, dolphins, and porpoises are classified as whales in the Cetacea order. Within the Cetacea order are two suborders, Mysticeti and Odontoceti. Mysticeti are the baleen whales. Whales like humpbacks and blue whales. Whales that use baleen plates to sieve planktonic creatures like krill from the water. Odontoceti are toothed whales like beluga whales, sperm whales, porpoises, and dolphins. Rather than baleen whales, these whales all have teeth that they use to catch their prey like salmon, squid, other marine mammals, and even shellfish like clams and mussels. Since we're on the topic, shellfish aren't fish. They're invertebrates, like mollusks, crustaceans, and echinoderms. So all dolphins are whales, but not all whales are dolphins, if that makes sense. Which means killer whales are both dolphins and whales. With that cleared up, let's talk about the second part of these comments. That they're not killers, or that calling them killer whales is degrading. For starters, most marine biologists call them killer whales because that is their official English name and the one used by scientific institutions like NOAA and the DFO in Canada. We don't typically use the Latin names of animals. For example, we don't call lions Panthera leo, and we don't call dogs Canis lupus familiaris. We call them lions and dogs. Also, the Latin name Orcinus orca loosely translates to whale from hell, from the kingdom of the dead or belonging to Orcus, who was the Roman god of death. So that is only really a better option if you just did not know that. The common name likely originated from European sailors and fishermen who saw the animals hunting and killing other whales and therefore called them whale killers. And that got translated into English as killer whales. Translation issues aside, a lot of cultures have names for killer whales that evoke awe and fear, such as blubber chopper in Norwegian, assassin whale in Portuguese, murder whale in German, and the feared one in Aleut. Until recently, no one really had a problem with these names because killer whales are apex predators. In fact, they are the top oceanic predator. One of the most remarkable things about killer whales is how they hunt. Quick content warning, we'll be talking about how each population of killer whales has developed strategic and unique hunting methods. If that's not for you, just skip to the next chapter. Some orcas kill great white sharks by gripping the shark's pectoral fin and thrusting it forward, causing the shark to flip upside down and become immobile, allowing the killer whale to feast on the shark's liver. You've probably seen the videos of orcas coordinating that wave wash to get seals off of ice floes. Sometimes killer whales kill just for fun. The resident killer whales who exclusively eat fish have been seen chasing and sometimes killing harbor porpoises, but not eating them. A lot of people don't believe me that some populations of killer whales almost exclusively feed on shark livers. So I'm thinking about doing a video on that specific behavior. Let me know down in the comments below if that's something that you want to see. And while you're down there, just hit that like and subscribe button if you're enjoying the video. The argument for calling them orcas instead of killer whales is that some feel the name killer whale demonizes them or gives them a bad reputation, and that orca is a much more neutral term. Some argue that this can help with conservation because more people would care about these beautiful creatures if they had less sensationalized names. Personally, and this is just my opinion, I don't believe this is true. The people who don't care that southern resident killer whales are going extinct in what is likely my lifetime also don't care that polar bears are in danger of that same fate. They don't care about the vaquita, and they don't care about monk seals. Changing a name isn't going to change that. In fact, I would argue that it could be more harmful to pretend that orcas aren't dangerous, because that just invites behavior like this. People swimming with them. Or getting their boats dangerously close to them. This horrifying incident happened today as of the time of filming, but this is not the first time. Just a year or two ago, a Canadian scuba diver was fined $12,000 for placing his boat directly in the path of the critically endangered southern resident killer whales and attempting to swim with them. Oh my God. This is part of why I've been pushing back against people who get mad at me for saying that the Gladys orca are sinking yachts. I believe it's vitally important to have a very healthy respect and in some cases fear of wildlife in order to give them the proper space that they need. Vessel strikes and noise pollution are serious threats to all marine mammals, and studies have also shown that killer whales hunt less and travel greater distances when ships are present. Protecting these animals will take a lot more than changing the name, and if you want to learn more about what you can do to help protect them, I've put links down in the descriptions and the pinned comment. The good news for those of you that disagree about this whole killer whale versus orca thing is that we are probably going to change their name in the near future. At least for the bigs and resident killer whales. Recent studies have shown that these two populations are genetically different species. Their Latin names will change from Orcinus orca to Orcinus ater and Orcinus rectipinus. Right? I hate that one. Rectipinus. Bummer. Like, are we gonna call them? This is ater. There goes a rectipinus. You see? Do you see? Their common names are likely to change as well, and it sounds like indigenous tribes and First Nations could have a role in their new names. Okay, so let's go back to that thing I mentioned earlier about false killer whales. They are also dolphins, but they're not killer whales. They were originally identified by a single skull sample in 1846 that was originally thought to be from a juvenile orca. It wasn't until several years later that people realized it was a completely different species. And so it was named Pseudorca, which roughly translates to false orca, or the false killer whale.